So the next topic I will discuss is cursors with for loops. So cursors with for loops will be very easy than cursors with basic loop. So when you are using cursors with basic loops, so everything must be done by us only, like declaration of cursor, declaration of percentage row type variable, and opening cursor, fetching cursor, closing the cursor. All these steps are mandatory, explicitly done. So in case of for loops, so except declaration of cursor, each and every step is done by for loop only, because for loop is going to provide that kind of flexible mechanism. Okay, for loop is going to provide that kind of flexible mechanism when you are using cursors with for loops. So what are the steps it is going to perform automatically? So it is going to perform these steps automatically. First one, the following steps. Steps are done automatically. So what are the steps done by for loop? First step is what? It declares a variable of percentage row type. In case of previous loop, we have declared it like prod or AC, prod percentage row type. That is not required here. Automatically that is done by for loop. And the second one is opens a cursor automatically. Opens a cursor automatically. And the third one, fetches a row into variable for processing. This is the third step. Next step is closes a cursor. Whenever all rows are completed. Okay, so these are the steps which are performed automatically when you are using cursors with for loops. These are the advantages of for loops, cursors with for loops over basic loop. So what are the steps it is going to perform? First, it declares a cursor of percentage row type. In the previous examples, what I said, prod or EC, I said what? Prod percentage row type. Okay, that declaration is mandatory in case of basic loop. But in case of for loop, automatically that variable is declared. Any variable you can declare, you can take automatically, that is declared as percentage row type variable. That is first advantage. Second advantage is what? We need not to write any open statement. In the previous example, what I wrote here, open cursor. Open cursor opens C1, I said. So that is not mandated, that is not required in case of for loop. So that is also done by for loop. And the next one is fetches. In the last application, what I did here, fetch C1 into prod REC. So that is also not required automatically, that is done by for loop. And finally, that means at the end of loop. So after end of the loop, just what I wrote here, close C1. So that is also not required automatically. For loop closes a row. Sorry, for loop closes a cursor. Okay, it declares a cursor automatically, opens a cursor automatically, fetches one rows one by one, and closes a cursor whenever all rows are over, whenever all rows are completed. And along with this, I want to explain cursor attributes. What are the cursor attributes? So previously, in the previous program, just I have given what percentage exit when C1 percentage not found. What is that actually? percentage not found is going to return true whenever a fetch statement fails to fetch rows from a cursor. So in the previous example, what I did, exit when C1 percentage not found, that means that is that must be given after fetch statement. That means whenever fetch statement fails, means when all rows are completed. So in the previous example, product table contains 4 rows. So when completion of, after completion of 4 rows, what happens here? The fetch statement cannot fetch any rows, okay, because all rows are completed. So in such case, the exit condition will be useful. That means here percentage not found is going to return true whenever a fetch statement fetches, whenever a fetch statement fails to fetches rows. Next, percentage found. So percentage found returns true whenever a fetch statement fetches rows successfully. And percentage row count. So percentage row count is going to return the number of row, number of rows fetched by current fetch statement. That means whenever the cursor fetches first row, the percentage row count becomes 1. And when second row is fetched, the percentage row count is becomes 2. Whenever third row is fetched, percentage row count becomes 3. Whenever the last row, fourth row is fetched, percentage row count is 4. That means as the rows are fetching, the percentage row count becomes incremented. The percentage row count value will be incremented by 1. Okay, always in the loop, percentage row count is going to give the current row, the number of rows fetched by the last fetch statement. Percentage is open. So this is going to return whenever a open statement succeeds to open the declared cursor. Otherwise it returns what? False. Okay, percentage not found, this is going to return whenever the last fetch statement fails to fetch rows. And this is going to return true whenever the last fetch statement succeeds to fetch rows. And percentage row count is going to return what? The number of rows written by the last fetch statement. And percentage is open is going to return true whenever a open statement succeeds to fetch to open the cursor, declared cursor. So these are the explicit cursor attributes. 4 are there: percentage not found, percentage found, percentage row count, percentage is open. Okay, so by using these we can maintain, we can handle cursors. Previously I have used what? Percentage not found I have used. So exit when C1 percentage not found. So all these cursor attributes must be prefixed by the cursor name, like C1 percentage not found, C1 percentage found, C1 percentage row count, C1 percentage is open. Okay. Okay, don't write. For C1 percentage not found. So like this we can make use of explicit cursor attributes. And now we are going to do one program, one PLS scale application on cursors with for loops. Just you have a look, called employee create table employee, just you say ID number 10, name written, I will give job, so character 10, salary number 7,2, bonus column so also 7,2, total salary number 9,2, table created. Okay, now insert few values, insert into employee values. First specify the columns, because I am not going to insert values into all columns. ID comma name comma job comma salary comma up to salary, bonus total salary we will calculate through PLS scale program. values, id is number. So id comma, then double quotation, single quotations, just you write name, job. After job, next you give id, name, job, salary. Salary, right? Id something like 70, or you need any value you can give. 601, name something like Ram, salary will give 10,000. ID, once again I am giving values, ID, name, RAM, job is something like manager, salary is 30,000. Six zero two, name is Raj, developer, salary is 20,000. Next value is 603. Krish, job is tester. Salary is 20,000. Okay, just have given three rows. Also insert one more row. See, 607. Name Krishna. Job clerk. Salary 10,000. Okay, just to look at the information, select star from employee. We have four rows: manager, developer, tester and clerk. And I will write one program for updation of bonus and total salary. Host notepad d colon Shiva by, this is I am going to do by using for loop. For loop. For loop cursor. SQL. Set server output on. Declare. No declaration, I think. No declaration. Just you declare. M bonus, this is for assigning bonus. M bonus, this is of employee, percentage bonus type. Then begin, you need not write any statement like open, just you declare the cursor, that's it. Cursor C1 is select star from employee. Open statement is not required, just you write a for loop like this. For I may use emprec in C1. Previously we said what? Select cursor name into variable. But in case of for loop, this must be reversed. For emp rec in C1. C1 is a cursor, emp rec is a percentage row type variable. So in basic loop, what you have to say? Fetch C1 into emp rec, prod rec. Here it must be reversed using for loop. Use loop, and you within the loop you check the condition. So what are the conditions you have to check? If the job equal to manager, I want to give 5000 bonus. If job equal to something like developer, I want to give 3000. Tester 2000. For others only 1000 bonus I will give. Just you have a look. If emp rec dot job equal to manager, then how much bonus I will give? M bonus equal to how much? 5000. Else if emp rec dot job equal to developer, then M bonus equal to 3000. Else if EMP REC dot job equal to tester, then M bonus equal to 2500. Else, that means for other job groups, announce M bonus 2000 or 1000, anything you can give. Else M bonus equal to something like 2000. Use end if and update employee table. Update employee set bonus equal to M bonus, where current of C1. End loop. Finally, update total salary. Update employee, that is not required in the loop, because total salary will be calculated only for one time, and bonus must be calculated for multiple times for multiple employees. That is based on job category. That is why I have written update employee statement. employee set bonus equal to within the loop. Update employee set total salary equal to salary plus bonus. End. Once again, just you have a look. I have declared a cursor. First cursor C1 is select star from employee, and after that I have declared one variable M bonus, that is for assigning bonus. M bonus employee percentage bonus type for emp rec, this is a record type variable, percentage row type variable, automatically that is declared. Loop, within the loop, if emp rec dot job equal to manager, for managers how much bonus I am giving? 5000. Else if emp rec dot job equal to developer, for developers how much bonus I am giving? 3000. Else if emp rec dot job equal to tester, M bonus equal to 2500. Else M bonus equal to 2000. End if. So finally, that means at the end of if statements, what I am doing? I am updating bonus. Update employee set bonus equal to M bonus. So this bonus is updated with M bonus, because in the M bonus variable we have stored bonus value. M bonus, where current of C1. This is for updating current row of C1. After end loop, just you update all the total salaries of all employees. Just you save it and see the execution. Better you include slash also. Just have a look of employee table. Select star from employee. Bonus is not there. Total salary is not there. Okay. I will calculate bonus and total salary by this PL scale program. Cursors. For cursors. M bonus is invalid identifier. So we have to declare it. Just so the see the execution part. Now according to our rules, the program has updated bonus and total salary. Just at the end, just you have to include this option for update of bonus comma total salary, because we are doing this program for updating bonus and total salary. Now depending upon job category, the bonus will be calculated. Bonus equal to 5000 for managers. For developers, M bonus equal to 3000. For tester, 2500. For any other group, if they are not managers or developers or testers, for any other group, bonus will be given as 2000. So within the loop, what I am doing here, update employee set bonus equal to M bonus. I am updating bonus with M bonus. So previously, I am assigning values into M bonus variable where current of C1. Okay, finally we say update employee set total salary equal to salary plus bonus. Select star from employee. See, for first employee, since he is manager, 5000 has given. For developers, 3000. Testers, 2500. For any other group, just have given 2000. So finally, I have updated total salary like this: 30,000 plus 5000, 35,000. Developer, 20,000 plus 3000, 23. For tester, 20,000 plus 2500, 2000, 22,500. For a clerk, 10,000 plus 2000, 12,000. Like this, you can use cursors with for loops, so that what happens here, your task will be made very easy. Okay, so every time you have to include for update option, for updation of a column, one or more columns. Without using for update option, you cannot update. Just you can print the values from the table, that's all, but you cannot perform any updation. That means if you are opening a cursor for updation of rows, you must have to include what? For update of bonus and total salary. In the very first session of cursors, I have discussed three versions. So just declaration for read only, declaration for updation, declaration of all columns. So entire things I have declared in the session. This is about cursors with for loops.